Hey guys, it's Adam here, and just a real quick intro before we go into our feature-length production. This project is essentially what I'm calling Back to the Future 5. It uses this game, Back to the Future, the game, specifically the PS4 version. And what I did was, much like the original movies, when they wrote Back to the Future 2, it was so big they had to split it into two parts, and that became Back to the Future 2 and Back to the Future 3. This game has so much content that in order to make any movie out of it, I had to actually split it into two pieces. Chapter 1 and 2 became Back to the Future 4, which hopefully you already saw, and Back to the Future 5 became Chapters 3, 4, and 5. Again, there was so much content in there that I had to remove. I highly recommend that you check out the game, actually pick it up and play it yourself so you can see those extra tidbits. But really, I just did this as a labor of love along with the first one. I just really love that franchise and I wanted to see a fourth and fifth film. So again, I do not own this property. It's property of Telltale Games and of course Universal Studios. They have no real association with me or my company, FigureItOut Productions. Again, just a labor of love. I just really wanted to make it. And if you haven't seen Back to the Future 4, but you're trying to watch this, go see that first. And definitely see the original film trilogy because you will be totally lost otherwise. Anyway, without further ado, please enjoy.
What's going on here? This is the dumbest design ever.
What the hell?
Hey, could you give me a... Jennifer?
Martin? It is you! Is that a DeLorean?
Well, yeah, it's a DeLorean. What else would it be?
How the hell did it get into the billboard like that?
Never mind that. What's the date, Jennifer?
It's the 15th.
The year?
1986. Duh.
Oh, man, this can't be happening. What are you wearing, Jen? You look so...
Fed up? Keen eye you got there.
I was gonna say punk.
A whole world alien to the likes of you, dork.
What's with the attitude?
I'm not having this argument again.
Never mind. I gotta get out of this car.
Good idea.
Could you call someone? A tow truck, maybe.
Get real. I'm in enough trouble already. I'm not gonna explain your DeLorean violating a billboard to anyone.
You got any rope you can toss me?
Uh-uh. All I have is this rusty wrench thing I found in the dirt.
I think that'll do. Toss it here.
Oh, back off, Martin. What do you give me for it?
This is all I got.
Give it here. Irving Kid Tannen? The gangster? Where the hell did you get this?
It's a long story. Can I just have the tire iron now?
Heads up!
Thanks. Oops. Oh.
Well, your dorkness, my debt to society is paid. As for you, good luck with your car. Way to stick it to Big Brother. Just don't expect your sudden cry for attention to change anything between us, dig?
Doesn't change what? Hey, maybe you can give me a lift into town.
Oh, sure, Martin. Climb on in.
Hey, Jennifer, wait!
I told you, we're through, McFly. I'll never date such a square again.
Jesus, could this get any worse? Whoa, whoa, whoa! These walls couldn't possibly go around the entire city, could they? Hi, can you buzz me in?
Welcome home, Citizen McFly.
Okay, Doc, let's see what kind of nightmare alternate timeline I've landed in this time. So clean.
Good morning, citizen.
And a good morning to you too, citizen.
First Citizen Brown, the mind head of Hill Valley, a man of infinite wisdom and awe-inspiring imagination. Emmett Lathrop Brown had been raised by a family legacy steeped in law, but hadn't set his sights on his destiny until he single-handedly thwarted the nefarious gangster Irving Kid Tannen and his bootlegging syndicate. After this heroic event, immortalized by the grand statue on the courthouse lawn, First Citizen Brown devoted his life to civil and social engineering, using Hill Valley as a prototype for tomorrow's cities today.
Watch where you're going, citizen.
Sorry. Mr. Parker.
That's Officer Parker to you, Martin. Now what's with the outfit? Polo shirt Thursday. You're out of uniform. That's a violation of Civic Ordinance 9EEE. And you're not wearing an ID, in direct violation of Ordinance WB714. What are you up to, citizen?
Polo shirt.
Are you on the pot, citizen? Put your arms up. Spread your legs.
Hey, what are you doing?
Quiet. Hold still. Nothing. What's your deal today, McFly?
What's with the pat down? What do you think, I'm packing heat?
Heat? Contraband?
Contraband?
You know. Booze, smokes, bubblegum, dogs, circus
bubblegum
peanuts?
Bubblegum is illegal.
Come on, McFly. You're smart enough to know that ignorance of the Civic Ordinance 2XM isn't an excuse.
Can you tell me where I can find Doc, Citizen Brown?
Are you sure you're an honor student? Where do you think he is at this time of day? I've got to finish my beat. Are you going to make trouble for me today?
No, sir.
That's right, citizen.
Courthouse, how may I help you, citizen?
I need to see Doc, Citizen Brown.
Do you have an appointment?
No.
Then I'm afraid you'll have to wait your turn. Citizen Brown is a very busy man.
Biff? Doc? I need to talk to you.
Hey, well, you're George and Lorraine's youngest. Martin, right?
You don't know me?
Only by reputation. Brown Cadet of the Month, 3 months running. Impressive. Are you interested in the Citizen Plus program?
It's Citizen Brown's new re-education program, and I'm the first of Hill Valley's Citizen Plus.
What the hell?
Please don't swear, Martin. It makes me uncomfortable.
What's the point of Citizen Plus?
Well, it may not be as noticeable for an upstanding citizen like yourself, but the hypnotherapy sessions help to tame the urges to break the rules.
Whoa. Hypnotherapy?
Well, sure, Martin. Why, it makes obedience automatic.
Obedience? Is this some kind of brainwashing?
Well, that's a good way to think about it. Scrubbing all those nasty thoughts right out of your noggin.
It's voluntary, right?
Well, sure, for the pilot program, but eventually it will be mandatory for everybody.
Mandatory? Are you nuts?
Did I mention the swell digital watch you get with the program? It's got all sorts of special modes programmed in. I still haven't figured out how to set the time, but I'm sure a smart guy like you could do it no problem.
What's Jen up to now? What's the deal, Jennifer? He left me stranded outside the city gates.
Do I look like the kind of girl that would hang around the president of the Junior Brown Brigade?
I don't know what the hell you're talking about, but I gotta admit, I kinda like you like this.
Barf?
Leech and the Whoosh Bags. I've never heard of them.
They don't play much punk on those smooth jazz stations you listen to.
Your paint's starting to streak.
Ugh!
Oh, don't be like that, Einie. See? I'm not such a bad guy, right? Whoa, okay. I guess I've won you over. I wish they were all this easy. Huh? What is it, boy? Einstein, wait! No! Oh, hell.
Oh, rabies! Rabies, help!
Back! Down! Sit! Play dead!
Officer Parker, subdue that beast at once!
Einstein, sit!
Einstein?
Oh, if he bites me, you'll be in a world of trouble, citizen!
Wait, I know that creature.
Officer Parker, that's the stray that keeps escaping the kennel. I thought he was muzzled.
I took the muzzle off.
Citizen, you are in violation of Statute 357K.
Parker, demerit this hooligan at once. I'll return this creature to the kennel.
Yes, ma'am.
Filthy, wretched beasts.
Don't worry, Einie. Once I fix all this, you'll be back with Doc and romping through time.
Now stay out of trouble, unless you want a visit from Citizen Brown.
Listen, Biff, that car I saw you get out of, was that Doc Brown in there with you?
Ha! Doc! Yeah, that should be his new nickname. But yeah, that was Citizen Brown.
How'd you get FaceTime with him?
Unfortunately, I'm a special case. See, Martin, I used to be a real bad apple. A real butthead.
You a butthead? No.
What can I say, Martin? I was always getting into trouble. Too much trouble. What with the booze, the party, and the women. After getting in so much trouble, the authorities, they took me in to see Citizen Brown and gave me an ultimatum.
So you won't break any rules anymore?
Can't. Now I get physically ill if I try to break a rule.
Sure you aren't craving a beer?
I do kind of miss beer.
So what? You wouldn't even defend yourself?
I don't know if I could, actually.
Wuss.
Oh, you're just aching to find out, though. Oh, please, Martin, don't make me angry.
What kind of trouble did you get into with women?
Public displays of affection, Martin. You know, necking and such.
That's illegal?
The Browns always say that behaviors that excite your private should be kept in private.
Do you think I could get to see Citizen Brown if I did all the bad stuff you used to do?
Yeah, I guess, but why would you want to act like that?
Hi there, Martin. I saw you as I was driving in. Did you hear me honking?
Mom, that can't be you.
Martin, are you all right?
I'm fine. It's just that you're so gray.
Well, isn't that an uplifting way to greet your mother?
Sorry, I just don't...
I guess you're right, though. I am going a little gray. No thanks to your father.
Are you out here shopping or something?
Who shops anymore? No, it's that time of the month for me again. For my civic duty. I'll be polishing the statue all day. Could you do me a favor? I forgot to give your father my timesheet for last week, and now Mr. Nosy is convinced that I'm hiding something from him.
Timesheet?
Aren't they annoying? But Citizen Brown always says, a scheduled life is a happy life. Anywho, could you be a dear and drop it off at the house? Here, take the car.
Actually, I know,
dear. Love you too. I'd give you a kiss, but you know what that gets ya. Don't forget to pick me up this evening.
Yeah, sure. Well, it's not the truck, but I guess it'll do.
I don't know, John. Isn't this illegal?
What isn't illegal in Hill Valley?
Shh. What if Citizen Brown's watching?
Don't worry, nobody can see us here.
He's a peeping Tom.
Ah!
Dad,
try to warn your old man the next time, okay?
I saw Mom downtown. She told me to give this to you.
Thanks.
Say, what gives around here?
You know, the usual. Keeping tabs on Hill Valley through my trusty bank of monitors. Always on the lookout for some interesting footage.
What do you mean, interesting?
What kind of silly question is that? I've been gathering candid documentary footage for Citizen Brown's promotional videos for over a year now. I know your mother doesn't approve of my work, but... Wait a minute. You say you saw Lorraine? 11 to 12 hair salon, 12 to 12:20 lunch at Supmo counter, cream of asparagus with crackers...
What was that?
You know your mother's problems. If she slips up again, it could mean demerits for the whole family. There she is, polishing the statue in the park. Just like the schedule dictates. Oh, then everything's fine. Good. Unless... How was she when you spoke to her? Lucid? Sober?
Whoa, Dad, what are you telling me? Are you saying Mom's a drunk?
Shh, I don't know for sure that your mother has relapsed into her old ways, but she's been acting very odd lately. Almost as if she didn't like my constant supervision. Confidentially? I suspect she's got a flask hidden somewhere.
Is there anywhere you expect me to be, like, right now?
Well, I did expect you to be up at the lake until tomorrow with that math and magic competition, so I guess your time is pretty much your own right now.
I'm trying to understand why Jennifer broke up with me in this time, recent past.
Are you still mooning over that girl? Forget her! She's bad news! Why, my surveillance cameras have caught her doing things that are completely against the Hill Valley Code.
I don't want to know.
Kissing boys. Sitting with boys in cars. I've kept quiet about it for her father's sake, but believe me, you're well rid of her.
Oh! Is that what you were trying to hide from me when I showed up?
I might as well tell you. After all, you'll be 18 soon.
Tell me what?
Hill Valley under Citizen Brown is not quite the contented town you were led to believe it was.
You're kidding.
This isn't a criticism of the great man himself, of course, or his sainted wife, Edna. No one's worked harder than they to apply the most advanced social planning techniques to our municipality, but...
What?
Confidentially, not everybody appreciates it. A great many citizens, perhaps even the majority, actively resent the Brown administration. They don't say so publicly, of course. But in private, well, just listen.
I tell you, Bert, this regime is a joke. They're all laughing at us over in Fairfax.
A toast to Citizen Brown. May his beloved courthouse be struck by lightning. Shh, Agnes, you're awful. Are you coming to the town square, Lester? Citizen Brown's about to give another speech.
Citizen Brown can kiss my hairy...
Well, you get the idea.
Does Citizen Brown know?
He should. Whenever I send copies of my raw footage to the public relations department over at the courthouse, I get a memo telling me how much Citizen Brown thanks me for my service. But how could he see those videos and not do anything about it?
Hey, what's my guitar doing out here?
Your mother and I convinced you to give it up, remember? Rock and roll music is frowned on by the Brown administration. It sets a poor example for all the kids who look up to you as a model of studiousness and moral gravity. And besides, you're not very good.
A certain girl is only gonna like me if I can play the guitar.
Oh, Martin. Why are you fixated on that little hellion? She's nothing but trouble.
My kind of trouble.
The way you play guitar, you're only gonna drive her further away. Go ahead, son. Do your worst.
Thanks, Dad. Soups and more. Wholesome soups, fresh vegetables, and soy-based imitation meats.
Okay. Welcome to Soup Mode, where soup is just... Oh, it's you. This better be important, McFly.
Leech, was that Jennifer?
Well, A, it's none of your business. And B, seeing as she ain't your chick no more, yeah.
Okay, now this timeline is really pissing me off. You and Leech, Jennifer?
Hey, don't badmouth Leech. There's a lot more to him than soup, you know.
Like what?
For one thing, he wields an axe like nobody's business.
So you got yourself a new guitar player.
What can I say? I'm a girl who appreciates a hot lick.
Yeah, I remember. Come on, Jennifer. Nobody in town plays guitar like me.
I'm talking electric guitar, Martin. I'm gonna be honest, the ukulele has to go.
I can outplay your loser boyfriend any day of the week.
You're that desperate to get to first base.
Did you say first or fourth?
I'd give you 2.5. But first you gotta prove you've got better fingers than Leech. You ready to throw down?
I was born ready.
You got a guitar?
Never leave home without it.
Hold on.
You can knock on my door anytime.
Hold it, we got company.
McFly, what's that was doing here?
He says he can outplay you. I told him, there's no one in Hill Valley better than you. Wanna go prove it?
The ring of rock?
Don't crush him too bad. Just teach him a lesson.
Say, some guys got it and some guys don't.
You broke my head, Doc.
I think I've got a new idol. Come here.
Wait, I got a better idea.
Oh.
Hooliganism! Delinquency! Officer Parker! I just caught these two degenerates violating statute number...
Jennifer!
Daddy! 476D!
Open mouths?
And tongues.
You've gone too far, Jennifer.
What's the big deal? It's only hormones.
We don't use words like that in this town.
I'll deal with you later, young lady. We're gonna have to have a long talk. About the Citizen Plus program.
What?
Oh, come on.
Officer, give Mr. McFly a 476D's worth of demerits. I'll tend to your wayward daughter.
Yes, ma'am. And this is for getting my daughter in trouble with Citizen Edna.
Mom? Mom, are you drinking again?
Your father. Why, I just can't get away from his prying eyes. Always spying, always watching. You mind your own business, George.
Now, Lorraine, this is for your own good. I know you're keeping a secret from me.
It's mine to keep.
Dad, Mom, knock it off, you two.
Huh? Where'd she go?
Mom?
Aha! I knew it. What is that in your hand? Rum? Gin? A wine cooler?
For your information, it's brass cleaner. I have a job to do here, you know.
What happened? What the heck am I looking at?
Shh. Mom, now that Dad isn't watching.
Oh, Martin.
Was that a flask, Mom?
Flask? Don't be ridiculous.
Look, it's okay, Mom. Get a hold of yourself.
Oh, your father's right. I'm backsliding. But it's been so hard. Oh.
Let me take care of the flask. Dad doesn't have to know anything about it.
Oh, thank you, sweetheart. I couldn't bear the thought of facing your father over this.
This timeline sucks. Mom and Dad are fighting again. Mom's drinking. It's like everything Doc and I ever did to fix things has fallen apart. Time to get some attention.
Hands up, citizen. Assume the position.
Here goes nothing.
There better be apple juice in this.
Why don't you open it and find out?
Don't get smart with me! I knew you were no good, McFly.
Officer Parker, what seems to be the problem here?
Citizen McFly, ma'am. Came strolling up with a 181B violation in his pocket.
Ugh. You, young citizen, where did you get that... booze?
Nowhere?
Is he being smart with me?
Yeah, he played that attitude on me as well.
Can we just fast forward the lecture and just get this over with already?
No!
Officer, demerit him severely. And as for the alcohol, drop it into the recycling bin.
With pleasure, ma'am.
Are you Martin Seamus McFly?
Yes.
We have a warrant for your detention.
Detention?
You've accrued over 15,000 demerits in the past 24 hours.
Cool.
Is it, young Mr. McFly? Is being branded as a criminal of weak moral character cool?
I'm not weak.
But you are in a heap of trouble.
Trouble?
Oh my, yes. But don't worry, we're here to take care of you.
Like your Citizen Plus program took care of Biff?
Perhaps. The program is in need of new volunteers. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. First, let's see what Citizen Brown has to say about your particular strain of antisocial behavior.
You're taking me to Citizen Brown?
Immediately. Officers, away with him.
Yes, ma'am.
It's about time.
I always knew your goody-two-shoes A-plus student act was too good to be true.
Come in, citizen. Martin McFly, age 18, resident of Sector L, father George, mother Lorraine, president of the Junior Brown Brigade, recipient of a full ride scholarship to Strickland College, winner of the Courthouse Challenge Deportment Award, zero demerits until this morning. The obvious question, Mr. McFly, is... what happened to you?
Jesus Christ, Doc, what happened to you?
Doc? Interesting. You regard me as a doctor. That's a hopeful sign, Martin. Of course, I'm not actually a doctor, but I do have the tools to turn you around and put you back on the road to societal normalization.
What you've turned into, it's all wrong. You're supposed to be a scientist, an inventor, and your hair. You don't look good, Doc. Listen to me. You don't remember it, but you built a time machine out of a DeLorean.
Why?
Well, just for the hell of it, I guess.
Fascinating.
Yes! Yes, it is fascinating. It's amazing. It's incredible. But you don't know it because you've never invented it. You're not the real Doc Brown. Everything got screwed up when I went back in time to 1931.
Sounds like this time machine is a very impractical and dangerous invention.
Think back. Don't you remember me? We knew each other when you were 18. I'm Michael Corleone.
Incredible. This case is more serious than I'd imagined. The boy has fabricated an alternate reality.
I don't understand.
No, I don't understand yet, but I want to.
You still got the movie ticket.
Indeed I do. A memento of my first date with Edna. I took her to see The Virtuous Husband.
You were supposed to go see Frankenstein that night. It was gonna give you the inspiration you needed to pull off your big demonstration at the Hill Valley Expo.
My darling wife is all the scientific muse I've ever needed. From my successful demonstration at the 31 Expo all the way up to my cutting-edge Citizen Plus program.
Successful? It was supposed to be a failure. So that's what Judge Brown looked like. I never actually saw him.
Of course not. He died before you were born. He was my biggest supporter. After my wife, of course.
That's a switch. Last time I saw your younger self, you and your dad had just had a big falling out over your decision to become an inventor instead of a lawyer.
Stop trying to confuse me! My whole life has been dedicated to the practical use of technology to shape a more efficient, orderly society. Ask anyone. It's a fact. You can look it up.
But you know better, right?
Wrong. Do you see this picture? I keep it close by me to remind me of the moment when my life's course became clear. August 25th, 1931, the day I single-handedly captured Kit Tannen, the scourge of Hill Valley.
Single-handedly? Could that be? I think it is.
What?
It's me, and you, the other you.
It is me, and you. But how? Michael? It's impossible.
No, it's science. Your science, Doc.
In this other world, the one you say you come from, am I happy there?
Very happy. You've got two great sons.
Sons?
Yes, and a fantastic wife.
Not Edna?
Not even remotely. And your invention. Jeez, Doc, you can go anywhere you want to. Anywhere in time. You're the luckiest guy in the universe.
And what about Hill Valley?
Hill Valley? You know it's got problems. A little bit of urban decay here, a little bit of crime there. It's a normal city. People are happy, mostly. And even when they're miserable, they're not miserable like they are in your Hill Valley.
Stop! We've worked for over 50 years, my wife and I. Every waking moment devoted to ridding Hill Valley of vice and disorder. And you dare to claim that our citizens are unhappy?
Yeah. Yeah, I do. I've seen it. They're just too afraid to speak up.
Afraid? Afraid of what?
Afraid of the consequences of their actions, Doc. You run this place like it's a police state.
Nonsense.
I can prove it.
All right then, time travel boy. You do that. And until you do, I'm gonna treat your wild story as just that. A story told by a madman. And I've determined that the best treatment is simply to let the insanity run its course.
Fine, but I'll be back with proof. Dad!
Pop out the tape, son. I think it's done rewinding.
Whoa, take it easy. Sit here.
Guess I blacked out for a minute there. Fell out of my chair.
Fell nothing. Somebody whacked you. That's not one of our bats, is it?
No. Curious.
Oh, wait, don't touch it. It's evidence.
Of what? Oh, why would anyone do a thing like that to a nice Sector L citizen like me?
What's the last thing you remember?
I was sitting right here, copying another incriminating scene onto my tapes. My tapes! What happened to my tapes?
Stay calm, Dad.
Are they on the floor? Do you see them? They're in a box marked raw footage.
Here it is.
Thank heavens.
Wait a minute. There's no tapes.
But I'm sure they were in there before.
Before whoever it was whacked you in the head and took them.
Oh my gosh, I've been mugged. Mugged in Hill Valley. They can't get away with it. Oh!
Don't worry, Dad. We'll get to the bottom of this.
What's the use? Even if we find out who took the tapes, we're not going to be able to get them back without attracting attention to ourselves.
Dad, listen to me. I mean, really listen. You and I both know that things aren't right here. Citizen Brown might have started with good intentions, but his Hill Valley's just made everybody miserable.
Shh.
He's gonna make things right for you and Mom and all of us. I can't explain how. You're just gonna have to trust me on this. But first, I have to show him your tapes to prove my point.
Oh, no. No.
Dad.
This scheme of yours. Maybe you know what you're doing. I can't say. But leave me out of
Dad.
It.
Dad.
I don't like trouble. I can't handle it. It's not in my genes.
Do it for your father.
My father?
Didn't he have something to do with putting away Kid Tannen, you know, way back when?
Yes. Yes, he did. Never be afraid to do the right thing. That's what he always used to tell me. Trying to remember which is the right feed.
Feed to what?
To the surveillance camera, the one in the yard.
Wait a minute. You have a surveillance camera trained on yourself?
Of course. Gotta cover all bases. Let's see. I remember cleaning the playback heads at 5:30. The attack couldn't have been very long after.
Oh, it's Biff!
But it can't be him. The Citizens Plus program has rendered him as gentle as a... kitten.
Huh?
That's not the way he's supposed to behave. Why, even the old Biff, Lorraine!
Don't lay into me, George. I've got something very important to say, and then I'm going to be leaving again.
I've got something important to say, too. I was attacked
it's
and
robbed...
It's
always about you, isn't it? You can't just wait and listen to my news. Oh, no! You have to go and beat me to the punch. I haven't had a drink all day!
Biff! Okay, that's weird. Why'd you attack my dad? You must have been hypnotized. Who put you up to this? Do the chicken dance. Yeah, he's hypnotized, all right. Could you do me a favor and go get my dad's tape?
Hey, Mr. Tannen. What's up? Is that McFly kid bothering you? Hey, you can't go in there! Hey!
Whoa! Holy smokes! What happened to him?
I don't know. No one's ever jumped into the decycling bin before.
Well, where does it go?
That information is above my pay grade. Oh, jeez. I'm in a lot of trouble now. Don't move a muscle, McFly. I gotta go tell Citizen Brown about this.
Well, here goes nothing.
Mr. Tannen, I put a lot of work into honing you as the first Citizen Plus. What on earth possessed you to assault a police officer and dive headfirst into the decycling bin?
Did I do all that?
McFly.
Strickland.
Go high, Martin.
Give me the tapes, Edna.
Mr. Tannen, please restrain our guest.
Stop! Hey, look over there! It's beer!
Beer? What's going on?
Biff Howard Tannen, obey your programming! You see, Mr. McFly, thanks to the enhancements I've made to the Citizen Plus program, I can bring even the most rabid of dogs to heel.
Look! Girly mags!
Boobies!
Tannen, listen to me!
Babes. Booze! What the? Mommy!
Tannen, get up, you useless slacker!
Come on, Edna, give the poor jerk a break.
A break? You sound like my wishy-washy husband, always trying to find the good in people, never wanting to accept the fact that some people are just born bad.
Maybe, but that doesn't give you the right to turn them into zombies. Now, give me my dad's tapes so I can...
You mean those tapes I erased while you were struggling with my zombie?
What?
Utopias are fragile things, Mr. McFly. Especially when overseen by minds as distractible as my husband's.
No.
Edna!
Doc?
Emmett, what are you doing here?
I came down here to investigate a troubling report involving Mr. Tanner.
Doc, you gotta stop her. She...
Silence!
Okay.
I was concerned there might be a flaw in my Citizen Plus program. Imagine my surprise when I found my wife perverting my life's work. Is this what it's all been about, Edna? All those years? All our struggles to cure society's illnesses? Just to create a world where free will can be turned off with a flick of a switch?
Oh, please, Emmett. You wanted this just as much as I did. Remember? If only we could tell someone to stay off the grass, and so help us, they would never tread foot on a well-manicured lawn again. That's what Citizen Plus does. It makes rules unbreakable. I only gave it the slightest of changes.
Enough! We will not have this discussion here.
But...
Go home and wait for me.
Fine.
Doc.
Father, what have I done?
I'm sure he wouldn't blame you for all this, Doc.
He was so happy when I gave up my childish dreams in favor of Edna's more practical pursuits. Are you proud of me now, Father?
I'm sorry about Edna, Doc. She didn't seem so bad back in 1931.
No, she wasn't. When we were first dating, she was so spirited, principled, compassionate. When did I lose her? Ah, enough wallowing. What's done is done. It's time to look forward.
Maybe, but maybe not.
What?
Your notebook from the other timeline.
Not this foolishness again.
Look. You can use it to repair the time machine and fix all this so it never happened. Everyone can be back the way they're supposed to be. You, Edna, Jennifer, my parents. Doc, you once told me if you put your mind to it, you could accomplish anything. Well, accomplish this.
There's a lot of empty pages.
The only one you need is right here.
Great Scott. Martin, this could work. It'll take time, of course, but once it's done, we'll have all the time in the world. Edna will be furious, but who cares? We've got a time machine to fix. Woohoo!
Martin McFly.
Edna?
It's almost impressive how many years of work and planning you nearly ruined in just a few short hours.
Where's Doc?
Oh, relax, Martin. We've got everything under control.
Doc! No! Doc! What? Where am I? Ah, Citizen Plus? Citizen Plus? Hey, let me out!
Make sure the McFly boy is prepped for his Citizen Plus treatment by the time I finish with my husband.
How is Citizen Brown?
I'm afraid it's worse than we imagined. He's gone completely antisocial.
Darn.
We're using every tool at our disposal to snap him out of it. But I fear that nothing short of a complete personality rebuild will bring our leader back to us.
And it's all McFly's fault.
Unbelievable, isn't it? One teenage hooligan has brought Hill Valley to the brink of ruin. I'll be tending to Citizen Brown.
Someone's locked up all my stuff. Jen? Hey, Jennifer!
Martin?
Ah, Dad, is that you?
Who else would it be?
What are you doing in the Citizen Plus ward?
Edna threw me in here.
She can't do that to my son. How can I help?
Could you let me talk to Jennifer?
Jennifer Parker?
Yeah, she's in the room next door.
Let's see, that'd be waiting room beta. Got it.
You're all patched in, son. Jennifer.
Martin, is that you? Where are you?
I'm over here, in the camera.
Oh, Martin, aren't you in enough trouble already?
Trouble? Jen, what are you talking about?
You know, with all the drinking and the PDAs.
Jennifer, what's wrong with you? You sound strange.
I used to be strange, Martin. But thanks to my First Citizen Plus treatment, I'm well on my way to becoming an average, well-adjusted teenager.
Jen, snap out of it. This isn't the real you. I mean, it's kind of like the real you, but not like the real you in this timeline.
Wow, that's...
I know, it sounds crazy.
I'd never call you crazy, Martin. You're just sick. I should know, I used to be sick too. But now, I never want to spray paint a Buick or listen to rock music ever again.
Could you hang around for a few minutes? It's nice to have someone to talk to.
I'll be here until the guard comes for me. Then I'll really have to tell him about how you're hijacking the cameras.
Oh, come on. Don't be a narc.
I'm not a narc. I'm a good citizen.
Hello?
What?
Let me out of here.
Sorry, sir, but Citizen Plus patients aren't allowed to exit their waiting rooms until the Citizen Plus treatment chamber has been suitably prepped for their procedure.
Can I take a look at my stuff for a second?
Why?
I, want to make sure my guitar neck isn't getting bent.
What?
Come on, man. My parents spent a fortune on that thing.
Fine. Back away from the door, sir. There. How's the guitar?
I guess it's okay.
Good.
The camera was high enough to see over his shoulder.
Nice work, Dad.
The combination is 2 left, 8 right, 18 left, 32 right.
Alright.
Hey, your guitar! I'm sorry I tried to throw it out.
Yeah, the guitar's pretty cool, but this is what I care about.
No fair making your dad all misty, son.
Okay, Jen, here's a little something I think you're gonna like. At least, I hope you still do.
Martin?
Jennifer?
Oh, Martin. Martin? What are you...
What's going on here?
I have no idea, sir. I was minding my own business when all of a sudden a horrible noise started coming out of that camera.
Well, that's not right.
Yeah, well, neither is this! No one scrambles my brain, you hear me? No one!
Yeah, Jen!
No time for small talk, McFly. We need to get you disguised so we can walk out of here. Calvin Klein underwear? Really?
There. How do I look?
A little short for a stormtrooper, but it'll have to do. Come on!
Now we rescue Citizen Brown. Get the hell out of here and get things back to the way they're supposed to be.
Whatever, just as long as I get to break some stuff. I've got a lot of pent-up hostility right now, you know?
Miss Parker.
What the?
Yeah!
I'm here to escort you to the lobby. Your father's waiting for you.
Can he wait? I was hoping that this attractive young man could take me on a tour of the facilities.
I'm afraid I really must insist, miss.
Relax, Jennifer. I've got everything under control.
Really?
Really.
Okay, then. But first...
What was that for?
For saving me, dummy. Let's go, officer.
You know, I'm probably gonna have to write you up for a PDA violation.
Don't bite me.
What? Can I have some of that?
feels like I haven't eaten in years.
No, that's tannins. He's not allowed to eat it until he's taken his pacification pill. For some reason, he keeps spitting it out on the floor. See what you can do.
I'm sorry about the discomfort, my love, but it's really all for the best.
Hi, Biff. Looks like your intercom's busted.
Oh. Hey, is that a public display of affection over there?
Where?
Sorry, it was just a shadow.
Just get back to work with Tannen.
Yes, sir.
Jeez, what have they been feeding Biff? Horse tranquilizers?
Me?
Yes, you. As you can see, that slacker of a technician is sleeping on the job again. Please be a dear and tend to the Citizen Plus control panel, will you?
Sure.
Jeez, where's the off button on this thing? Volume. What the?
Where's Martin?
I'm sorry about the delay, dear. This'd go a lot easier if you just gave up this madness about time machines and altering the past. You should concentrate on the future.
There is no future for us.
You won't think that in a few more hours.
Check. Sibilance, sibilance.
What was that?
Hey, Doc. Let's get ready to blow this joint.
You! What are you doing?
Getting my friend out of here, you nutcase. Okay, that was a little less dramatic than I had expected.
Whoa!
Go, Your Honor.
What? I can't hear you!
You're welcome!
After him, you slackers!
Attention, citizens. This is an Omega-1 priority alert. Potentially disruptive nonconformists are loose in the courthouse. Please return to your homes until the situation has been resolved. Have a nice day.
What do we do now?
Now we wait for the glass to clear out so we can make a break for your time machine.
Where is the DeLorean anyway?
I had the wreck towed to my secret lab near Clayton Ravine.
As in Clara Clayton?
Why is that significant?
Well, Clara's kind of supposed to be your wife, so yeah.
Looks like the coast is clear.
Great! Let's go fix the DeLorean.
I'm afraid I'll have to do that without you, Martin.
What? Why?
Well, from what little I understand of time travel, if you help me rebuild the time machine, your presence in the repair efforts could cause some sort of temporal paradox after we return to 1931.
So what am I supposed to do? Just hang out here in Bizarro Hill Valley until you fix the time machine?
Exactly. But don't worry. If things work out according to plan, you won't even notice I'm gone.
You know, for a second there, you sounded almost as confusing as the real Doc.
See? We're making progress already. See you soon, Martin. Oh, and you might want to stay off the streets for a few seconds.
Stay off the street?
He's not coming back, you know.
What are you talking about?
Emmett. Without me to guide him, he's almost useless. Before I found him, he was a miserable failure who never finished anything. But with me to inspire him, look at what we've built!
I'll have you know that without you, Emmett Brown is destined to build a time-traveling DeLorean and a flying time train.
Preposterous. Emmett couldn't even build a dog feeder without me to guide him.
Well, he did that, too. Okay, Your Honor. Starting to get a little concerned here.
It worked! Ha-ha! 1 second I'm in the present, the next I'm 6 months in the past! Amazing!
6 months? It took you 6 months to repair the time machine?
6 months, my family fortune, and a sketchy deal with a gang of Libyan nationals. But it was all worth it for this moment.
Ah! Emmett, don't do this. You need help.
Oh, blow it out of your exhaust port, dear. Now that I've escaped into the past, your pack of divorce lawyers can't... Martin, how long have you been waiting for me?
A couple of minutes, maybe.
That's curious. I set the repair time circuits to arrive only a couple of seconds after I left. Oh, well, I'm sure there's no need for concern. It's probably just a minor miscalibration of the time circuits. Here.
What's this?
Clothes for our trip. We can't have you traipsing around 1931 in that ridiculous outfit.
Wait, our trip?
You didn't think I was going to let you erase the worst mistake of my life without my help, did you?
Leave! I'll ruin you, Emmett! I run this town!
Time circuit set for August 26, 1931. You ready to go, Your Honor?
Call me, Doc.
This is where I last saw him. You. Teenage you. You were headed this way, arm in arm with Edna.
Ugh. Luckily, my erstwhile wife was never the type to kiss on a first date. If we work fast and stay focused, we can see to it that our relationship never moves beyond the hand-holding stage. Well, will you look at that? The Old Town Theater. I haven't thought about this place in years. The missus made me tear it down back in 71. Said the movies were corrupting the younger generation. It was all nonsense, of course. I spent countless evenings here in my youth, and it never turned me into a hoodlum. Say, remember Public Enemy? Why, you dirty rat, no good yellow-bellied stool. It never did manage to see Frankenstein, though.
But you're going to. That's what we're here for, remember?
Right, of course. The film that was supposed to set off a chain reaction in my imagination, inspiring me with a notion that would launch my scientific career.
You've still got no memory of what that notion was?
Well, how could I? It happened in the brain of a different Emmett Brown. An Emmett Brown now erased by the shifting sands of time. I do know something about my own brain, having lived in it for the past 70 plus years. Once we get my younger self re-inspired by that movie, nothing will distract him from his proper... Great Scott, will you look at that?
The town square?
It's just like I remember it, only dirtier. Oh, the old courthouse.
Come on now, Doc, you need to... Go inside and check it out. First rule of time travel, Doc, never allow your other self to catch sight of you. It could cause reality to collapse or something.
You mean?
Right behind you. Don't peek. Go on. I'll let you know when you're gone. And don't forget, you're Carl Sagan.
The billions and billions guy?
The suspected arsonist.
Huh?
Just go with it.
Michael, you do show up at the oddest moments. Where have you been hiding?
Oh, you know, here and there. You're a little hard to pin down yourself. I went looking for you last night, but...
I believe I was off entertaining a beautiful lady. You know, I never really got a chance to thank you.
Well, I'm sure you would have escaped Kid on your own.
Kid? Oh, sure, I'm grateful for that, but no, I'm talking about Edna. It's funny to think of now, but until that crisis, I actually thought Edna and I disliked one another. Imagine!
Yeah, well, sometimes first impressions are right. The thing is, you shouldn't let Edna distract you from, you know, the business at hand. Finishing your project for the expo and going to see Frankenstein.
Oh, pshaw. I'm far too busy for movies these days.
But,
And as for my project, it's practically done.
The rocket car?
The rocket car? Boy, are you out of date. I've junked a rocket car.
But...
more trouble than it's worth. I'll never figure out a propulsion system that does what I want it to do. And besides, its social utility is practically non-existent.
Social utility? Since when do you care about...
The mental alignment meter is a much more worthy project.
The what?
It was Edna's idea, and she's really been cracking the whip to get me to complete it in time for the expo.
What day is it?
The opening day of the expo! Which reminds me, I'd better skedaddle back to the lab. If Edna catches me dawdling, there'll be heck to pay. Catch you around, Corleone.
October 12th?
Come to think of it, it is a bit brisk for August.
Oh, we're 2 months late. The expo's about to start, and teenage you is already in over his head with Edna.
I always did have a tendency to plunge into things.
Let's plunge into the DeLorean and get to the right date.
No, it's far too risky. Remember how I was late picking you up in 86?
Yeah?
That should have been a tip-off. Something is horribly wrong with the time circuits, and the problem appears to be getting worse. If we try to jump now, we could find ourselves stranded in the Cenozoic Age. Or worse, the Mesozoic.
Then we're stuck?
For the time being. I'll look into the problem and see what I can do. In the meantime, you can go to work on the other problem.
Right. I'll go to the lab and see if I can talk teenage you
out
of...
Impossible. If young me is already as infatuated as you say, you're not going to be able to talk him out of anything. Believe me, I remember. Better to focus on the more clear-headed half of the couple.
Edna? Where can I find her?
I'll drive.
You were right. There she is.
My soon-to-be ex-future wife is nothing if not predictable.
Do I really have to talk to her? I mean, couldn't I just hang out until you fix the time circuits and...
Oh!
I'll talk to her. You better get the DeLorean out of sight before someone...
Hey, you! Quit blocking the drive! All Car of the Future contestants need to report to the North Tent!
Why not? Good luck!
Spell it! B-R-O-W-N. It's not exactly an obscure name.
I still don't see it on the list. I'm sorry.
Oh, for the love... Let me try this one more time.
Oh, dear.
Mr. Corleone! Have you seen Emmett?
Yeah. Just now, in the town square.
Oh, then you've heard all about his big breakthrough, the mental alignment meter. Isn't it exciting? And to think, he didn't even realize the import of his discovery until I pointed it out to him.
I kind of wanted to talk to you about Emmett, and his potential.
Funny, I didn't spot it myself at first. In fact, for the longest time, I thought I didn't even like him.
I don't get it. I mean, Emmett's nice and all, but he's not exactly the kind of guy that has girls swarming all over him.
He cleans up surprisingly well. I gave him my grandfather's white suit to wear at the expo. Oh, you should see him in it. He looks positively radiant.
Looks good in a suit. Got it.
And he's completely devoted to me. That's important. I've got no time or tolerance for playboys.
Faithful as a Labrador. Check.
Thirdly, and most important...
Yes?
Well, his mind, of course. It's brilliant, and it's virtuous through and through. His own mind map shows him to be a model citizen.
Good brain, I see. And if it turned out that you were mistaken about any of these qualities...
Say, what's your game?
Just curious.
Well, understand this. I'd have to be thoroughly disillusioned before I'd call it quits with Emmett. Got it?
Uh-huh.
Now, Mr. Cub Reporter, is there anything else?
Hey, Audie. You seen my Oreoli?
You mean this?
Yeah, thanks.
She gets to come and go freely, and I'm forced to wait. I love it. I won't stand for it. As a socially conscious citizen, I demand you discharge that muse.
Trixie? What's wrong with her?
Oh, she's hardly qualified for an honorific post at a public event.
Look, lady, she fits the costume, she's an American citizen, and she managed to memorize all her lines. What more qualifications do you want?
Hey, Artie.
Officer.
Officer?
Oh, right. Don't blow your cover.
Will you please keep your mind on the task at hand?
To all who approach these hallowed halls, I bid thee welcome. To all who... Oh, hiya, kid. Say, aren't you the fellow who...
Got you to turn on Kid Tannen? You bet.
You look younger without your mustache. That was a dirty trick, you know, making me think Kid had gone and iced Artie.
I'm sorry, but it was the only way I could...
Forget about it. I'm trying to. Yesterday's in the past. That's my motto. You gotta live for today.
Listen, I've got a proposal for you. I have this friend, right?
No dice. I'm only seeing Artie now.
It's not like that. See, my friend's in a relationship with Edna Strickland.
Oh, poor schmuck. I wouldn't wish her on anyone.
You see where I'm coming from. He won't listen to reason, but I thought she might call it off if she thought he and you were, you know.
You are an evil imp, ain't ya?
Sometimes a guy's gotta resort to underhanded tricks. What do you say?
Edna might be a pill, but if I play dirty tricks on every dame who disapproves of me, well, I'd play a lot of dirty tricks. Besides, such stunts are beneath the dignity of Techni News of Progress.
Ah, good. You're back. Give me the full report.
She says she likes you because you've got a virtuous mind, you look good in a suit, and you're completely faithful to her.
Damn, she's got me dead to rights. Well, you'll just have to find a way to change her mind.
I suggested a little scheme to Trixie, but I don't know if she's gonna go along with it.
Pursue whatever strategies you like, but please, don't tell me the details.
Any chance I could borrow the DeLorean? I want to drop in on young you at the lab.
Well, I don't know. The time circuits...
Listen, I promise, I won't take it to 88.
Even so, I'm worried about letting it out of my sight while it's still behaving unpredictably. Tell you what, I'll take it on a test drive 1 minute into the past. If it passes the test, I'll let you borrow it.
It worked! Didn't it?
I'm afraid not. In fact, the discrepancy appears to be getting worse. I arrived 6 hours ago.
Oh, too bad.
I didn't want to risk undoing any of the work you've done thus far, so I kept out of sight. But the time lag wasn't entirely a waste. I stopped by the hardware store and bought the parts for a chronometric analyzer.
A what?
A diagnostic device. See, I plug it into the time circuits and set them to cycle. When the green light goes off, I should have the data I'll need to understand the scope of the problem.
Hey, no driving the exhibits off the lot!
Looks like you'll have to find another set of wheels if you want to get to the lab.
My future wouldn't be built so shoddily.
Hi, Miss Strickland. I was just...
Break what you like. Just keep away from Emmett's booth. Speaking of whom, I'd better go see what's keeping him.
I'll go check on him for you.
The last thing he needs is another distraction at the 11th hour.
But...
Tut tut. Not another word. I've got the rest of the day all mapped out.
Miss Strickland!
Carl Sagan?
I'd like a word with you, if I may.
I'm not sure it would be seemly for me to be seen in the company of an alleged arsonist.
I think it may be in your best interest. You see...
Let's go somewhere where we can talk privately.
Go. I'll keep her occupied till you get back.
Thanks again for your assistance, Detective Parker.
Detective? What the hell is Kid doing here?
Nothing criminal, I assure you. I was just getting a mind map of Mr. Tannen for our exhibition at the Expo. The authorities wouldn't allow Edna and I to stage a demonstration of the mental alignment meter with a violent felon, but this little baby is just as good. Okay, let's see now what's next. Check the stew, sort the maps. Ooh, I almost forgot that.
Edna really is cracking the whip, isn't she?
Well, yes, but she's got my best interests at heart. Without her, I can get so distracted. Did she send you down here to check up on me?
Yeah, she wanted to come herself, but...
She's busy too, I know. Well, you're a poor substitute for Edna's lovely features, but make yourself at home.
Thanks.
No thanks are necessary. Without you, I'd never be where I am now. In love with a woman of my dreams, and a mere 6 hours from my first public triumph as a scientist.
Hey!
The test subject wears this mind-mapping helmet, which probes the brain by measuring fluctuations in skin conductance and electrical resistance on the surface of the parietal lobe.
Uh-huh.
When I turn on the mind-mapping helmet with this radio switch, the subject is exposed to a series of visual stimuli, intended to provoke a series of positive or negative responses, as indicated by these lights on the helmet.
Hey, is that...
As the responses are recorded, they're relayed to this special typewriter, which prints out a punch card that represents the subject's mind map. Observe as I place your mind map into the MAM.
Is that machine calling me a slacker?
No, your own physiological responses did.
What's this?
That's a can of used motor oil, rocket fuel waste, and assorted chemical sludge left over from my abandoned rocket car.
Gross.
Would you mind disposing of it on your way out?
Sure. What's cooking?
That's an old brown family recipe for Hassenpfeffer.
Hassenpfeffer?
The trick is to add the cumin an hour after the carrots. Take a whiff. Isn't that just about the best thing you've ever smelled in your life?
It's, powerful, yeah.
I've got it on a slow boil for later. I'd be careful of that if I were you.
Why?
Well, the rocket fuel experiment must have stripped one of the teeth in the hand crank. As a consequence, if you turn it for more than 10 seconds, it...
Whoa!
Sends out an electric shock.
I guess she's supposed to provoke a positive response.
Ow!
That's John Wilkes Booth.
Careful. Don't let all the flavor escape.
I don't know who that is, but he's clearly a Tannen. Okay, Emmett. Get ready to meet the new you.
Hey!
What?
I almost left behind my mind map card. We're gonna show it off at the expo as a rare example of a model citizen. Edna'd kill me if I forgot that.
Hey, Emmett. I've got a... Whoa! Whoops.
What the heck?
Oh, jeez, I'm sorry. Your suit's ruined.
Wrong.
What?
When Edna gave me this suit, I realized that the probability of me keeping it clean was infinitesimally remote, so I spent a few hours whipping up this.
Whoa! What was that?
A chemical compound capable of wiping the grime off any surface.
Damn it, you'll make a fortune.
Not anytime soon, I'm afraid. Due to an inherent instability in its molecular makeup, after 12 hours, the cleanser's component chemicals break down into a series of cloth-shredding enzymes, rendering it unsuitable for commercial use.
Wait a minute, does that mean your suit's gonna dissolve in 12 hours?
Hey gods, no. The solution dissipates into the air after it's applied. But it does mean that after this batch of cleanser ages another 11 hours and 53 minutes, it would eat away this suit faster than 1,000 starving moths. And that would be a crisis of unimaginable proportions.
That cleanser doesn't seem very portable.
It isn't, but this is...
A perfume bottle?
Yes, it's a perfume bottle, but inside is a concentrated dose of my all-purpose cleanser.
Clever. What the hell is that?
What?
I've got to go out for a while.
I thought Edna sent you to make sure I wasn't getting distracted.
Well, you'll be fine. Hey, pal.
Oh, geez, this guy again.
Shouldn't you be in jail with the rest of Kid's gang?
I was, but then an opportunity availed itself and I...
Sang like a canary.
I prefer to think of it as exhibiting an admirable sense of self-preservation.
You be playing piano for Trixie later?
Nah.
Why not?
Cause little Miss Goody Two-Shoes thinks she's too respectable for cue ball these days. Listen, kid, me and Trixie go way back. I know stuff about her that even kid doesn't know.
Really?
Yeah, like I'm gonna tell you.
Tell you what, I'll tell you something embarrassing about me first.
Like what?
My mom made a pass at me.
All right, Junior, you win. That was pretty embarrassing. Almost as embarrassing as this.
Trixie?
Yep.
She's not wearing much.
She did a lot of these artistic postcards a few years ago. I got a whole set of them.
Can I, have one?
You ain't gonna do nothing bad with it, are you?
I'll only use it for the greater good.
Well, okay.
Hang loose, pal.
You talk funny, mister.
Can I talk to you, Miss Strickland?
Surely. Excuse us a moment.
You might want to take a look at this.
Why in the world would I be interested in... Oh, what have we here? Mr. McFly! It appears your muse has been inspiring more than progress.
Trixie? Oh, no, no, no. What are you doing with a dirty postcard?
What is she doing in a dirty postcard? I swear, Mr. McFly, if that doesn't convince you that Trixie Trotter is unfit to represent Hill Valley...
I don't need you to lecture me about who I can or can't hire, Miss Strickland. Trixie's darn good at what she does. I don't care if she was once the winsome wench of Winnipeg. Her past doesn't matter to... Trixie?
What is it, Audie?
You know I don't like to pry, but what state did you grow up in?
Province, Manitoba. Why?
Not even an American.
See, darling, the charter specifically states that the Expo's hostess must be a U.S. citizen, so if you're really a Canadian...
I'm being fired?
I don't want to.
Here, take it back.
Well, I'm glad somebody's listening to reason.
Let's talk.
The light's green.
Excuse me, my dear.
About that gizmo you've got hooked up to the DeLorean? The light's gone green.
Excellent. Let's hope this time my test run is a success. I'm sorry to desert you.
Yes, well, you've left me with plenty to think about.
Any luck this time?
Depends what you mean by luck. My arrival time was off again.
By how much?
8 hours this time. Gave me the chance to take in 3 showings of Frankenstein. Good movie. A bit implausible from a scientific perspective, but I can see how my younger self would have been mesmerized.
What about the DeLorean?
Oh, yes. I did get one critical piece of information. The chromium elements in my circuits became unstable during the temporal shift. I should replace them with titanium.
Great!
Now, unfortunately, titanium won't become commercially available till the crawl process is perfected in 9 years.
9 years?
But there may be another solution. I'm going to fire up the chronometric analyzer again. Then, while I'm stalling in there, you can... Uh-oh. Where did it go?
The lab!
You better get down there before she makes the situation impossible. I'll tend to the DeLorean.
Age to perfection. Hey, Emmett, I'm back.
Oh, my!
You know, I thought you were coming down here to keep Emmett focused on his invention.
She's generously scheduled brief canoodling breaks every 45 minutes to keep my mind fresh.
Time's up, dear. Let's get back to work.
Shall we?
Now, Mr. Corleone, what can I do for you?
Mr. Sagan says he needs to talk to you back at the high school.
He does? Whatever for?
He says he's got a lead on the speakeasy arsonist.
Well, I'm not sure anyone cares about that old story anymore. But I suppose I could spare a few minutes in the service of solving a crime.
Will you be all right without me, sweetheart?
It'll be tough, but I think I'll muddle through. There it is. I've been looking all over for my portable anti-stick anti-stain formula. Where'd you find it?
Out by the trash.
That's strange. I haven't been out there for hours. As soon as I get all this stuff loaded into the truck, I'll be ready for the expo. Go on ahead. I'll meet you there.
I really hope this works.
Marty!
Doc!
I think I got it all worked out. When it all comes together, Edna'll think you're the worst guy in town.
Well, don't go to too much trouble.
What do you mean?
You see, I've been mulling things over, and... in the timeline you're from...
The right timeline?
Yes, yes. I've got a wife.
A great wife. Clara, and kids, and a dog. And a bitchin' time train, and...
And Edna? How does her story turn out?
To be honest, she ends up kinda... sad.
Sad?
She lives with some cats in a dinky little apartment, and... she spends most of her time yelling out her window at people, and collecting newspapers, and living in the past.
I see. Perhaps we've been going about this problem the wrong way. Do we really have to completely obliterate my timeline so we can restore yours?
Doc?
Maybe we could have the best of both worlds. I could be with Edna, but it could be a little bit, you know, more healthy.
She tried to erase your brain.
Oh, she was terrible, no argument. Horrible. Oh, but she started out with such... pure intentions.
I don't believe this!
All I'm saying is, let's stop and take a breath. This elaborate plan to derail my younger self's love life, is the short-term misery worth the long-term gain? Maybe we can find a third way. One where everybody wins.
I'm sorry, Doc. I can't go along with what you're saying. You don't belong with Edna.
So you're determined to break us up, in spite of my stated wishes.
Basically, yeah.
Then there's nothing left to say.
Where are you going?
Why should it matter to you? Aren't you planning on overriding me?
Wish me luck. Oh, for Pete's sake.
You've, got something on your suit.
Oh, so I have. Anti-stain formula, work your magic. Just in the nick of time. Step back now. We're gonna need a little space here.
Oh, aren't you a vision? Like something that descended from the heavens.
Yes, I'm feeling a bit elevated at the moment. There's something I've just gotta ask
you. Wait, your tie's a bit crooked.
I've been holding it inside for weeks now, and I've simply gotta get it off my chest.
Oh. My grandfather's suit!
My formula!
Oh.
Oh, look! Turn your head! I'll be right back and we can try this all over
and
again.
And it's Lathrop Brown!
Huh?
Trixie Trotter? How do you know this woman?
I don't. I mean, I listened to some of her records and I may have taken a picture or two
yes.
of her, but I...
Go on. Deny to the world that you know me. Perhaps it is true, but I know you all too well.
What is going on here?
You rich boys are all alike. You think material possessions can compensate for a broken heart? Well, you can take back your furs, and take back this gaudy diamond,
Ouch!
Too! I don't need your expensive presents. I need you! And more importantly, little Emmett Jr. needs you.
Edna, I...
Don't Edna-me. Apparently you are not the man I took you for.
But I am. Mental alignment meter proves it. I am the man you fell in love with.
Let me see that card. I should have known. A degenerate criminal.
What?
Get out of my sight! I never want to see you again!
That was rough, Emmett. I'm sorry you had to go through it, but things are gonna be okay. You and me can... Emmett?
That went off great, huh?
Yeah. Maybe too great. Emmett!
They say I'm crazy, got no sense, but I don't care. They may or may not mean offense, but I don't care.
Stop!
You did this to me.
Did what?
I was perfectly content drudging away in my dad's law office. You show up out of nowhere, get me all excited about inventing, and disappear. 2 months later, you show up again, you trick me into making a hero out of myself and getting involved with Edna Strickland. Then you appear a third time and pretend to be my friend just so you can yank the rug out from under me and send me sprawling into the dirt. I loathe you, Michael Corleone.
My name is Marty.
Oh, so everything you've told me has been a lie.
More or less.
Why? Why did you ruin my life?
I did it for fun.
You ruined my life for fun?
Yeah. That's how I get my kicks.
You bastard! And all that time you spent building up my dreams, telling me I was gonna be a great scientist!
Yeah, what a laugh. Dreams are only for people with guts enough to follow them.
You're saying I don't have guts?
You? Look at you!
What do you know? A person like you? You don't know the first thing about me. I have more dreams in my little finger than you'll ever have.
Hey, daydreams don't count.
Daydreams? That's what they said to Edison. That's what they said to Einstein. And look what they accomplished. I'm sick of people telling me what I can and can't do. First my father, then Edna, now you! Listen to me, good. From now on, I'm living my life my way. I'm taking my own advice and I'm following my own ideas. My ideas, do you hear me? My ideas. Great Scott, I've got it.
Got what?
The solution. My invention. I know how to make it work.
The mental alignment meter?
No, my airborne personal transport device.
The rocket car?
Not rockets at all. That was my mistake. The basic idea was sound, but the propulsion system was unworkable. But the lightning! Suddenly the answer is clear. It came to me all at once, like...
A bolt of lightning?
Exactly! Static electricity! Super ionized static electricity powering the asynchronous oscillation of frictionless plates inside the... What's this stupid thing doing on my head?
Emmett! You're you again!
Here, I've been wasting my time with silly mind-reading tricks when there's serious science to be done. And the expo begins at 8!
Let's get the hell out of here before anything else happens!
What?!
I said, let's get out of here before anything... Gotcha! Hold on!
What did you say your name was again?
Marty.
Marty? Thanks.
Don't mention it.
Tungsten. The catalyst will need to be made out of tungsten, given the temperature within the converter will no doubt be intense. We'll have to harvest the filaments from all the light bulbs in my house.
Your invention? You think you can finish it before the end of the expo?
Think? I've got to. My future depends on it.
Then let's go.
Of course, the oscillating plates will need to be calibrated precisely. Even the slightest misalignment could cause the magnetic field to fluctuate in intensity, leading to sudden shifts in polarity. The results could conceivably be catastrophic.
Who cares?
My thought exactly. Science should be messy and unpredictable, or else where's the fun of it?
Need a lift?
Mr. Sagan, got the kinks worked out of your car of the future?
Not all of them, but at least the DeLorean's mundane terrestrial functionality remains intact.
As usual, I have not the slightest idea what you're talking about. In fact, you remind me of someone I used to...
There, my dear, don't worry. I'm sure we'll all turn out well in the end.
Maybe for everyone else, I should get a cat.
Nonsense. I can state with nearly 100% certainty that you're going to have a long and fulfilling life.
How can you know that?
I think you'll find I know almost everything worth knowing about you and young Emmett and his friends. Tell me, how much do you know about Michael Corleone?
Hello?
Marty! You're awake! Good!
Emmett, where are you?
I'm down at the expo. I snuck out early to avoid my pop.
Why didn't you wake me up?
I left you back at the lab to perform an important mission. On the table next to my law books, there's a device plugged into the wall.
I think I see it.
Is it glowing?
Yeah. Is that good?
Good? It's fantastic! Glowing means my static accumulator is charged up and ready for action. Bring it down to the high school and we'll... Damn!
What?
It's Edna!
But... Yeah! Jeez, Doc. Watch out! You almost ran me over!
Sorry about that, Martin. This vehicle is sometimes difficult to control.
Yeah. Hey, are you okay?
I'm fine. So is that what I'm destined to build for the expo?
Yeah, it's a static accumulator. Emmett spent all night building it. Turned out he didn't really need to see Frankenstein after all. He just needed a little push. And some lightning.
I also had an epiphany last night.
Doc?
I realized that it wasn't Edna that made my life miserable.
Doc!
It was science!
Can't want Emmett back with Edna. She used you to turn Hill Valley into a police state.
If I don't become a scientist, she'll never get the chance to vent her crazier ambitions.
No! Ah! What the hell? Where'd it go? Oh, come on! Gotcha!
The future is coming today. There's a shiny new tomorrow on the way. A day of invention is at hand. It's a mystic, futuristic wonderland. Just around the bend, my friend, you'll see a dream or two. If you care to dream and dare to dream, your dreams can all come true. A world of wondrous wonder on display, because the future is coming today. There's a world of wondrous wonder on display, because the future is coming. It's almost here now.
Not bad, eh?
Not
bad at all, but I thought you fired her.
I found a loophole.
What kind of loophole?
Just a loophole. You're not the only one who's allowed to have secrets, you know.
All right. Wait a minute, that's Emmett's levitator up there.
Oh, don't be so modest. I'd say you deserve at least half the credit. It was you who tricked poor Emmett into breaking up with me. It was you who manipulated him into dropping my project in favor of this clear hazard to public safety.
How do you know this?
I had a very interesting chat with Carl Sagan. I found out who Michael Corleone really is and where he comes from.
Is there something you want to tell me, Michael?
Why don't you call him by his real name? Yakov Smirnoff.
Thanks a lot, Doc.
An anarchist! A foreign agitator bent on sowing chaos and destruction in the Hill Valley Expo!
Danny, you don't believe any of this bullshit, do you?
Sorry, Yakov, but I really don't have a choice.
Very good. And now, arrest this subversive!
Come here. Look, here's the thing. I happen to believe this dame's got a screw loose, but she's been getting some clout in town. ever since that business with Kid Tannen.
But Emmett's gotta fly that electrokinetic levitator at this demo. His whole future depends on it.
And my future depends on making sure he doesn't. The chief reads her column religiously. Well, if I don't do what she says, she's gonna start a campaign to have certain tainted officers removed from the force.
Isn't there anything I can do?
Not unless you've got some dirt on Edna. Something that'll discredit her in the eyes of the law.
I'll dig something up.
You do that. In the meantime, you and young Mr. Brown better... Where is he, anyway?
Wait, you haven't seen him?
Emmett? Has this foreign radical done something to my Emmett?
Maybe you should find him.
Oh! You're letting him go? This radical subversive? Just like that?
Hi, Trixie.
That's techni to you, kiddo.
Right. Congratulations on getting the old job back.
Thanks. Justice triumphs in the end, you know?
So, which exhibits do you recommend?
The most popular attractions are the glass house, the future furnishings, and of course, Enlightenment Under the Sea.
You know who that is under the diving helmet?
That's Jacques Dutot himself. Of course, you need to get tickets if you want to see the main attractions.
How much are tickets?
Aw, put your money away. Here.
Thanks. Look, Emmett's demonstration has hit a snag, or two. Can you delay his act for a while? Let someone else go before him?
Sorry, I don't set the roster, and they won't let me change it.
Hey! Emmett! Come out of there! Don't listen to him!
Welcome to the Atlas House of Glass, the future of domestic life.
Emmett!
Atlas Glass, unbreakable and soundproof. Welcome to the world of tomorrow, where a man's home is truly his castle.
Where'd you take him now, Doc?
Here, gratification is just always a push of a button away. In the house of the future, phone conversations will be completed in the privacy of the personal phone helmet.
Please recite the phone number you wish to dial. Or say, hang up, to terminate your phone helmet experience.
Hang up.
Conversation terminated.
Hey, Danny, could I have a word with you?
Comrade Smirnoff, come to turn yourself in?
In private?
With pleasure.
A potted plant? What's this got to do with law enforcement?
A potted plant? What's this got to do with law enforcement?
It's a bug.
No, a plant. But it's got a wire recorder hidden inside, see?
Emmett's been kidnapped by Carl Sagan.
Stop making up stories.
Really? He knocked him out in the House of Glass?
Well, when you find the master criminal that's kidnapped your friend, bring him over here, and we'll have a nice talk, okay?
Well, did you put the screws to him? Did he confess?
Okay, this is pointless. I've got to find Emmett. Excuse me, sir. I'm looking for a tall, thin, older gentleman. He might have been with a tall, thin, younger gentleman.
I know. Just who you're talking about. Hey, just left not a minute ago. If you hurry, you might catch that.
I know you're in there, Doc.
Doc? Yes, I am a doctor of marine biology, but I fail to...
Quit fooling around, Doc. What have you done with
Emmett? Stop! Help! I'm being attacked!
Michael! What are you doing? You can't assault the exhibitors!
You don't understand. He's kidnapped Emmett.
The boy's obviously, confusing.
I'll say he is.
You want I should toss him out on his ear?
That won't be necessary. Do you know who that is? That's Jacques Dutot of the Oceanic Institute.
No, it's not. It's...
Please keep it down. The Expo went through a lot of trouble and expense to secure Professor Dutot. We can't afford to antagonize him.
But...
If you've got a complaint against him, we can straighten it out after the show. But if you make another scene like that, I'm afraid I'm gonna have you expelled from the hall.
I want to see inside that bathysphere.
I don't think so.
What do you mean? I've got a ticket. You have to honor my ticket.
It's the wrong kind of ticket. Sorry.
Next up on our roster, a man who saw the possibilities in pond scum. Welcome, Ernest Philpott!
Thanks, Trixie.
Professor Duteau, this young man claims you refused to take his ticket.
Not at all. I am only too happy to take his ticket. Please, climb the ladder, and I will raise the bathysphere. Mon Dieu! What is the matter? The gears, they must have become stuck. I am afraid I cannot raise the bathysphere at this moment.
What a shame.
Yes, it is. Well, I will work on the problem. Perhaps if you come back later.
Step back! You're crimping the hose!
What does it matter if there's nobody in the bathysphere?
It's very bad form.
You ready to drop the act now, Jacques Duteau, a.k.a. Carl Sagan, a.k.a.
No!
Emmett gets no air until you raise the bathysphere.
Emmett? Who?
I'm just gonna keep holding this air tube closed.
I wish you wouldn't.
You know what happens when the air runs out, to both of you.
The laws, the gears, they have become unstuck.
There, see? It was just a malfunction after all.
Let's get you out of there.
Emmett Brown? Then it was true. Hey, you!
What's this?
Oh, yeah. Edna made Detective Parker shut down your booth. Unless we dig up some dirt that'll discredit her in the eyes of the law.
The next exhibitor on our list is Officer Danny Parker of the Hill Valley Police Force. Officer Parker is going to demonstrate a few of the many marvelous tools that our boys in blue will soon have at their disposal. The criminal element has truly met his match today. Officer Parker? It seems our next exhibitor is unavoidably detained, but I'm sure his presentation would have been both enlightening and exciting. How about a round of applause just for the heck of it?
Welcome to the phone booth of the future, made with Atlas Glass. Atlas. Unbreakable and soundproof. Our phone is hands-free, so you can enjoy a sandwich or a cigarette while chatting with friends in perfect privacy. Unfortunately, this phone booth only accepts incoming calls.
Welcome to the world of tomorrow, where a man's home is truly his castle. Here, gratification is just always a push of a button away.
What? Klondike 4253.
Expo, where the future is coming today. This is Checkney News of Progress. To whom am I speaking?
This is Carl Sagan.
Ooh, the mysterious Mr. Sagan. What do you want?
Can you put Edna Strickland on the phone for me?
Sure thing, Mr. Sagan. Hey, Strickland! Somebody actually wants to talk to you.
Mr. Sagan? What happened? I thought you were distracting Emmett.
I was.
Oh, yes, of course I was.
Then why is Emmett standing here, valiantly trying to convince Detective Parker that he should be allowed to go through with this ever-so-dangerous display of wrong-headed technology? You were supposed to keep Emmett distracted, but it appears that you've been foiled by Mr. Smirnoff.
I think we should let Emmett go through with his demonstration.
Dangerous, and that Yakov Smirnoff was a foreign agitator. That the only way I could get Emmett back would be to scoop him up after his dreams were shattered and...
Yarding, you know what?
You know what?
The little matter we were whispering about yesterday.
Oh, that? As a matter of fact, I'm glad you brought it up. I was thinking, wouldn't it be a good idea to pin it all on Yakov Smirnoff? Oh, I get it. You're still sore about going to jail. That was the dog's fault. If he hadn't come glumping up to me right after I started the fire, I could have gotten clean away, and I never would have had to divert suspicion to you.
She's the speakeasy arsonist.
Carl, is somebody with you?
No, it's just you and me. You know, I don't think I ever asked you why you burned down all those speakeasies.
Why? Because no one else was doing anything about them. Every night they'd open up their doors serving illegal drinks and loose women, flaunting their depravity to the world, and the authorities did nothing. So I did what any right-thinking, rock-willed woman would do. I took action. Oh, and such a gorgeous action it was, too. The fires were so beautiful. The alcohol made them go up in such pretty blue flames. Oh, where was I?
Hang up.
What?
Conversation terminated.
Hey, Danny.
Our plant recorder.
It's not a good idea to steal police property, you know.
Shh, listen.
You know, I don't think I ever asked you why you burned down all those speakeasies.
Why? Because no one else was doing anything about them.
Edna? You're the arsonist?
Detective Parker, surely you're not going to believe this crudely manufactured forgery of a recording.
I'm not sure what to believe, ma'am. But based on this crudely manufactured forgery, I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask you to come down to the station to answer a few questions about your whereabouts on the night of the speakeasy fires.
Emmett?
You're on your own, darling.
Oh, very well. Heavens, what's that?
You know, one of these days I should really stop falling for that.
Not to sound callous, but does this mean I can demonstrate my invention?
Let's take that as a yes.
Greetings and salutations to all our honored guests. I am Techni, Muse of Progress, and it is my pleasant task once again to highlight one of the great minds who was hard at work building a better tomorrow.
I think that's me. I'm next on the roster.
But are you ready?
No, I don't have a choice. Did you bring the static accumulator?
Oh, right. Here you go.
Great. Come on, let's get up there.
And who knows? One of this kid's gizmos just might take off and change the life of everybody in town. Could it be the very thing he's brought to share with us today? It wouldn't be the first time the
world was changed by a kid barely... That ought to do it. Are the block bearings all in the raised position?
Block bearings. Raised position. Check.
Then it looks like all systems are go. Wish me luck.
I don't have to.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Emmett Brown.
Objection, Your Honor. I hereby demand that the scientific demonstration of Von Emmett Lettre Brown be terminated and forfeit by reason of insanity. I declare him to be in contempt of me, his father. Where is he? Hand him over this instant!
Come on, Mr. Judge, sir. You're kind of making a scene here.
Wrong. I am stopping my son from making a scene here.
Don't antagonize him.
Well, if you're not going to say anything...
So he is up there with you.
Thanks a lot.
Son, I order you to come down from there this second.
You've never understood the first thing about me. All you want to do is step on me, squelch my natural instincts. You don't know what it's like to be young.
You
don't know what it's like to have dreams, to have ambitions so great and so powerful that they've got a life of their own. And it's all you can do to hang on for dear life while they gallop on where they must. This is America, Pop. And in America, a person doesn't have to do what his father did. Isn't that why you came to America? To live where there wouldn't be so many rules? Well, we talked.
Emmett's just trying to make a name for himself. Maybe things were different when you were a kid, but nowadays you gotta take chances.
Try moving to a strange country where you don't speak the language. There's only $2 to your name.
You?
You bet your socks, me! And I made out all right, too.
How'd your dad feel about it at the time?
Papa? He was fit to be tied. He called me a disobedient little...
So your father didn't approve of you coming to America?
Well, Papa never really understood the younger generation. He came around a bit in the end, but by then it was too late to. May I come up?
So, you think my new invention is a disaster waiting to happen?
Yes, yes I do. And I'm here to say, if any son of mine is going to make of himself a public disaster, I insist on being there to support him.
Pop! You're gonna change your tune once you see this baby go airborne. You see, the force field generated by the static accumulator... Marty, give Trixie the signal. We're ready for liftoff.
Oh, good. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for bearing with us through that unavoidable delay.
Thought I could change her. Things could be different.
Forget about it. Come on. We gotta find a way to stop her before...
No, don't come any closer.
Doc!
Go away!
But...
Move! Move! Marty!
Say something.
Chromium, lithium, potassium, iridium, titanium, ruthenium.
I'll get help.
Newspaper.
What? You mean... I'm gonna get you to a hospital, Doc. You're gonna be okay.
Yes. Oh, I think I am going to be okay, Marty.
No, come on, Doc. Doc, don't do this. Don't go.
Marty, have you been out here the whole time?
Emmett, is it over already?
Oh, it's over all right. You missed a very wild party. I'm afraid I've been banned from the Expo for the next 50 years. And if I were you, I wouldn't go back in either. At least not until all the broken glass is swept up. Oh, what was I thinking? Naturally, the ionic wind generated by an electromagnet of that size is going to play havoc with a merely mechanical steering mechanism. We need a much more advanced control system. I wonder if we could find a way to translate the body's own gravitational field into electrokinetic force. One might be able to direct the ionic current simply by shifting one's weight. Well, great Scott, that's it!
What about your father?
Oh, yes, I suppose I should wait for him to finish dealing with the officials. I can't say he was exactly thrilled with the unexpected turn my demonstration took. But you heard him in there. He understands that a life of science has its ups and downs. The way I see it, it's those little mistakes along the way that advance us along the pathway of knowledge. Come on, there's no time to lose. Let's get back to the lab and... I'm sorry, is something wrong?
It's a long story. Let's just say I lost somebody.
Oh, how sad. Anyone I know?
Yeah, no, forget it. It's got nothing to do with you. What?
You're a complete mystery to me, Marty. Where you come from, what you're doing here. But there's one thing I do know. Whatever it is, it does have something to do with me.
Please, Emmett, don't ask
any... What's this? What's that?
An explanation. You've got to promise me, don't look at it until you get the key to the city.
Huh?
Emmett!
Just promise.
Emmett, where are you, my son?
I'll be right there, Pop. Key to the city? I don't understand.
And you can't understand. Not for a long time. It would do irreparable damage to something. Just say you promise.
Okay, I promise. Wait, I will see you again, right?
I guarantee it.
Emmett!
Yeah, it worked.
So, you were the same Marty. Funny how memory can play tricks on a person. I remembered you being much taller. You've got a theatrical way of sending messages.
Only way I could do it without messing up your timeline.
Very clever. But what are you doing in 1931?
I came to stop you from marrying Edna.
Edna Strickland? I could never marry her. I mean, she was my first love, but after she broke my heart and tried to sabotage my career, I never saw her again.
Where is he? Where is that no good son of mine? He's not worthy of the McFly name. You see my Artie anywhere? Artie McFly? That's the one. Just got a call from Melvin at the city records office. He tells me the dad blamed Fool's gun and got himself hitched to a Canadian floozy. Can you believe it? Hitched? Married. I swear, that boy's gonna put his papa in an early grave. So that's how she got her job back. Ah! He's married the wrong grandma. I mean, Trixie's not my grandma. And if she's not my grandma, I'm not me. Wait, that was Great-Grandpa Willie. I met him when he was a baby. He peed on me. Holy crap, Doc, I'm gonna disappear again.
Calm down, Marty. You seem reasonably solid right now. Whatever the problem is, I'm sure we can undo it with the help of...
Car!
Oh, great.
How the hell did she get back here?
She?
You? You're not Edna. What's going on here? Is this some plot to put me in the nut house?
No, it's all very simple, Danny.
Oh, I'm sure it is. Tell me, Did I or did I not just chase Edna Strickland off in this car?
Edna Strickland just disappeared in the DeLorean?
If that's what you call it. It made a loud noise, and then wham! Nothing!
Great Scott! Marty, do you have any notion what date she might have jumped to?
None at all, Doc. See, that DeLorean's time circuits are out of whack. They could jump to any date at all.
Oh, this is bad. This is very bad. Let's just hope she jumped into the future. The far future. If she's jumped into the past...
You think she might mess up the time stream? Wait a minute. This is Edna. Of course she would mess up the time stream.
Guys, you mind telling me what the hell you're...
Uh-oh. Doc? Did we just leave Hill Valley?
No, I believe Hill Valley just left us.
How?
Something must have happened to it. A long time ago.
Well, now you two look a mite lost. Hey, what on earth is that thing?
It's an experimental vehicle. Pay it no mind.
We're looking for Hill Valley.
Well, which is it, a hill or a valley?
No, it's a town. It's a town called Hill Valley.
Hill Valley, a town? Say, I think I once heard that there was a town here a long time ago. That was all before I was born.
Then whatever it was must have happened at least 45 years ago.
Nobody much cares to settle around here nowadays. My dad tried to buy a farm in this area years ago, but he got run off by Scary Mary.
Scary Mary?
Well, that's what we all call her. Lives a couple miles from here. I make a monthly drop at her place. She's a fiend for news. Takes all the papers in the county, never throws one away. Say, if there's anybody who can tell you what happened to Hill Valley, it's her.
Can you direct this to her?
It's imperative that we talk to her.
The thing of it is, guys, Mary's older than dirt. She doesn't like strangers.
We'll be very polite. Please, you gotta see her.
Well, okay, if you insist. Take a right turn just after the bridge, then follow the wheel ruts till they come to an end. You'll have to go the last quarter mile on foot. Good luck, and don't say I didn't warn you. I got a notion I'll be kicking myself for sending you up there.
Step away from the cabin!
Pardon us for intruding, madam. We were wondering if you could tell us...
I don't talk to hooligans!
On a very friendly sort.
Doc, that was Edna.
Edna Strickland?
This is how she was when I first met her. I had to... Listen, just leave it to me. Hey, Miss Strick.
Who are you?
Look hard. Don't tell me you don't recognize your own boyfriend.
My boyfriend?
Yeah, he's all grown up.
Come closer, fella.
Marty, what am I supposed to do?
Trust me, Doc. Just go with it.
It is. It's October 13th, 1931. Oh, and you are Emmett. Emmett, stay there.
It's a classic case of repressed memory syndrome. Once the mental dam is broken, the subject is immediately plunged into the midst of the very scenes she's trying to forget.
Darling, you've come back.
Of course I knew you would. An intelligent boy like you wouldn't be one to throw away true love all because of a silly quarrel. I've already forgotten about last night's little tiff. I trust you've done the same?
Of course I have.
Of course I have. What?
Schnookums.
You're sweet. But you're still keeping company with this Smirnoff character. I insist you drop him. He's a bad influence. And you've got to stop working on that dangerous electrokinetic... What's this?
Okay.
I suppose now you're miffed with me for forcing Detective Parker to close your booth down. Bitter medicine for you, I know, but I had to do it. And Parker had no choice but to obey my orders. He knows that my opinion carries a lot of weight in Hill Valley, and he'd never... Parker would never... Oh... Officer, I can explain. It was a trick. I was framed. Oh, he's after me! Ha! He'll never catch me in this souped-up car of the future! Curses! I can't shake him. Well, no use in holding back now. Let's see what this baby can do. And here it comes! I'm being transported.
Where?
Back to the past.
What do you see?
Hill Valley. But it's all different. It's so small and primitive. Heavens! Can it be? It is!
Is what?
Grandfather! Big as life! How well you look, how well everything looks!
How does everything look? Tell me.
It's a bit rustic, to be sure, but all the buildings are so sturdy and well kept, and the young people of Hill Valley, they're so virtuous and upright. So unlike the degenerate specimens from the 20th century, and I know the reason why.
Why?
They haven't yet fallen prey to the vices of booze and debauchery. They are still in a state of innocence. I think I could learn to like living here. But who's this?
Who?
This big lout swaggering up the street. Lips curled in an insolent sneer. He's a newcomer to Hill Valley. Beauregard. Beauregard...
Cannon.
Yes!
Good guess.
Look at him. Acting like a big shot. Throwing his money around. Stolen money, no doubt. Why can't they see through him? The two-bit phony! A saloon? In Hill Valley? Oh, he can't do that! Grandpa, you can't let him do it! You can't let that snake ruin paradise! Well, if they're all too blind to stop him, I'll just have to take the law into my own hands. First, we'll need some kerosene. Apply it liberally to the building site. No sense in being parsimonious. And now, watch. Isn't it beautiful? The devil's handiwork consumed by the fires of righteousness! Burn, you sucker! Burn!
She was never this passionate when we were dating.
Oh.
It's not staying in the saloon, is it? It's spreading to the other buildings in Hill Valley.
My intentions were pure. It wasn't supposed to happen like this.
But it did happen like this. And you've been repressing it all these years because you can't stand to admit that you're...
A hooligan! I'm a hooligan!
Did I lay it on too thick?
Here's the story. Black and white and red all over.
Huh. Hill Valley destroyed by fire. Started approximately 2 a.m. July 17th, 1876.
Of course, I'm not the real criminal in this story, am I, Mr. Sagan? You set me up for a fall. You and Smirnoff. You made me steal your infernal car! You made me burn down Hill Valley! And now, by the powers invested in me by the town of Hill Valley, I hereby sentence you two criminals to...
Hey!
You! How much have you heard?
Enough for a month's worth of headlines in the Hayesville Herald. 2 months worth if you shoot those fellas.
I could shoot you too, you know.
But you won't, because that would be against the law. And you never break the law, right? This is your cue to skedaddle.
Right.
Much obliged.
There's Beauregard Tannen's half-finished saloon. Sometime during the next hour, Edna's going to light it on fire and accidentally burn down Hill Valley.
I wonder where her DeLorean is.
We'll find it later. Right now, we've got to stop that fire. I'll go around back, you go through the front.
Got it.
Who's there?
Edna, stop. It's just me.
Mr. Sagan, what are you doing here?
I was gonna ask you the same question, Miss Pickford.
Isn't it obvious? I'm putting an end to your den of iniquity before it starts.
I don't think so, Mary. I don't like shooting women, but no one comes between Beauregard B. Tannen and his livelihood.
Tannen, stop! If you shoot her, she'll drop the torch and this whole place will burn up. Edna, stop! If you drop that torch, he'll shoot us!
Looks like we're at something of a standoff here, Mr. Tannen.
I don't see a way out, unless somebody manages to disarm both of you at the same time.
How the hell am I supposed to do that?
Why are you so hellfire determined to meddle in my affairs, woman? You've been a-burring my behind for over a month now.
You're the source of the hellfire around here, Tannen. I'm just fanning the flames a little.
Lady, I'm just giving the hard-working folk of Hill Valley a place to play some cards, look at some dancing girls, and knock back a few drinks.
Exactly. 100 years from now, Hill Valley will erect a statue in my honor.
If you go through with this, there won't be a Hill Valley 100 minutes from now. Maybe we can come to a more peaceable solution, Mr. Tannen.
Keep your distance, Fancy Pants. I don't know you from Adam, but that won't stop me from putting you in a box next to your crazy girlfriend.
I'm not his girlfriend.
Looks like your torch is getting a little dim there, Miss Pickford.
It's still hot enough to bring down this little bit of Gomorrah, Tannen. Are you here to haul me back to 1931 for my supposed crimes? Or is there some sort of time court for that kind of thing?
Time court? What in the name of Ulysses S. Grant is she talking about? What was that noise?
What noise? I didn't hear a noise.
Why are you dressed like that?
I wasn't planning on visiting the 19th century today.
And I wasn't planning on shooting a couple of lunatics today. Won't be long now.
We'll just see.
What kind of odds would you give me that I can disarm you and douse the young lady's torch simultaneously?
Got any last words?
I'll see you in hell, Tannen.
You first, lady.
Come on, you son of a...
The hell are you?
I'm the diversion, butthead. Nice one, Doc.
Don't tell Claire. She thinks Fisticuffs set a bad example for the boys. Now, where's Edna?
Doc, she's gone. Edna's DeLorean.
Okay, Edna, nothing to be worried about. You're a smart woman with a strong moral compass. You just need to think your way out of it. Oh, fudge!
What's she doing?
I think she's spouting euphemisms at us. Luckily, the road out of Hill Valley is still pretty rough in 1875. It's unlikely she'll manage to accelerate 88 miles an hour anytime soon.
How are we gonna stop her?
Good question. We can't risk injuring her or damaging the vehicle for fear of altering the timeline even further. Luckily, those diagnostic lights my alternate self put all over her DeLorean have given me an idea. Here, take these.
What are these?
Flux synchronization modules.
How do they work?
I generally use them for maintenance purposes, but we might be able to use causes them to sync up with the alternate neuron's diagnostic modules, thus making it possible to link both sets of time circuits and override the time destination of the alternate DeLorean.
Great plan, I think.
We could just snap them over the diagnostic lights.
Wait a minute, Doc. You want me to go out there? How the heck am I supposed to do that? A hoverboard! Sweet!
You okay?
It's just like riding a bike.
You ready to make the jump?
Ready, Doc.
1, 2, 3, jump!
Whoa!
Nice form, Marty. How's the reception on the wireless?
Great. Where'd you get these?
21st century video game consoles.
All right.
Great. That's one flux sink down.
Then I must be back in... Would you be kind enough to tell me what day it is?
It's the day I place you under arrest for arson, resisting arrest, and being a general all-round pain in the ass.
No! You can't arrest me. Not now. I just got back from the last century.
Would you look at that? Edna Strickland, drunk as a skunk.
I'm not drunk, you reprobate. I'm a time traveler.
Sure you are. I'm loving this.
I'll bring it to you. Come with me. We can do the whole day over if you want. We can fix everything.
We can start by drying you out. Come on, into the station with you.
Stop it! Unhand me, you dolt!
Well, I guess that's it for Edna.
Yes, I suppose it is. You know, whoever said time heals all wounds didn't know squat about time travel.
What do we do about that, DeLorean?
No need to do a thing. Ever since we synced up the time circuits, the temporal breakdown in Edna's DeLorean has accelerated at an exponential rate. By my calculations, the timeline should catch up with it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, now!
What the hell? Hey, Parker!
You're not gonna believe this!
Ready to go home?
Wait, Doc! The timeline's not fixed yet. Look! Michael! I heard a rumor about you two.
I guess we gotta come clean. Ta-da!
This just isn't right.
Now, I know marrying a Canadian for a work permit isn't strictly by the book, but hey, sometimes you gotta go out on a limb for the ones you love.
Isn't he just the sweetest?
Can you see through me?
Nope, never could figure you out. I thought you'd be thrilled for us.
You don't understand. You're supposed to marry Sylvia Miskin.
But I did marry Sylvia Miskin.
What?
You didn't think my real name was Trixie Trotter, did ya?
Don't feel too bad. It was kind of a surprise to me, too.
Wait a minute. You're Grandma Sylvie?
Grandma? Hey, how old do you think I am, kiddo?
But you're so... so skinny and blonde and...
Huh. Yeah, you know, it's amazing.
Oh my God. I've seen you naked. You're Sylvia?
You okay, pal?
Yeah, I'm fine. Great. You kids go off and have yourself a wonderful honeymoon. And don't worry about your dad, Artie. I'm sure he'll come around.
Come around to what?
To approving your marriage. You seem kinda mad about it back at the high school.
Well, that was before I got a look at her. Besides, as my dear old father Seamus used to say, no sense in getting riled up over something I can't do nothing about. And honestly, now that I met her, I can't imagine a better daughter-in-law than the charming Miss Sylvie here.
Aw, thank you, Dad.
As for you, stranger, I'll thank you to not go poking your nose in McFly family business.
It's been a pleasure, Agent Corleone.
See you in the funny papers, Mikey.
Goodbye, Grandma.
You know, I took some pictures of Trixie in 1931.
Hey, that's my grandma you're talking about.
Here we are, back in good old 1986.
May 14th?
15th. Best to build in a little lag time. Gives you a chance to catch up.
Looks like the estate sale is still going on. Hey, don't you want to stay, Doc? You gotta stop the bank from selling off all your old stuff.
What are you talking about? Estate sale? Bank? I'm not dead, Marty. Clara and I are having a little garage sale, that's all.
Garage sale? You mean...
Marty, you're back from your trip. Hello, Doc. Selling off the family treasures, eh?
Not quite, but I hope you find something you like.
Speaking of which, did you find what you were looking for?
Yeah. I sure did.
Great! Hey, is that a box of Asimov?
Let me get this straight. Are you telling me you live here now? In 1986?
Well, naturally. Claire and I maintain a part-time residence here. Wasn't that the case when you left?
No.
Strange. I can't imagine not sticking around. After all, I've got my late father's foundation to supervise. If I wasn't here, who'd present the annual Earhart Brown Scholarship for Young Scientists? Something funny?
I'll explain it to you later.
I don't see what's so funny about looking after a family legacy. Oh, almost forgot. I've got something for you. Happy graduation.
Graduation? But that's not for another... The McFlys of Hill Valley.
An exhaustively detailed history of your family, from your great-great-grandfather Seamus to the present.
You traveled through time to write this?
Well, most of the research was done traditionally, but your grandma Sylvia proved to be something of a mystery.
Which is why you traveled back to 1931, to look for her.
Exactly. Who knew she was singing in a speakeasy under a stage name?
This is great, Doc. Thanks.
Doc!
Marty, what are you doing here?
You gotta come with me, back to the future!